Nice one, Phil, thank you very much. Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, family and friends, all of the loved ones, and Robbie. We finally made it, and I'd like to thank you all for coming to me. It's great that it's been home. You can hear me, can't you? I've lost track now, so... I'd like to thank you all for coming. It means a great deal to me at home having you here, especially after we mucked you about for the previous three. At one point I thought it wasn't going to happen, but unfortunately, love, you're in the bag, your opportunity to run has gone. The past few years haven't been easy. The one thing I know I can take from it is the strength of the family I'm married into. Yeah. Phil, Tracy and Nancy, and now Alex and Ava, from the off, you've welcomed me, overfed me, turned me into the Harlem Guinness drinker of the planet. We've been through a lot together and I am proud for you to be my family.
Yeah, we love you.
Tracy, your daughters, the love you give to both your daughters reflects and hope so clearly. And Phil, we've cried over pints. You've given me advice over pints, and I couldn't ask for a better father-in-law as well as a mate to have many pints in the future. So, both of you, thank you for welcoming me to the family, and I'm sorry you got the sore end of the deal. Mum and Dad, the early days, I really didn't give you an easy ride. Dad, I'm sorry for the early hair loss. Three-man slingshots and cutting off girls' ponytails at school would just be honing on a career choice. You've always been there for the past 4 years, and you've been a great support to me at home. Not many parents would smuggle £3,000 worth of cannabis on me. Sorry, Uncle James, the drug smugglers. So, thank you, Mum and Dad, you've been as great at drug mules as you have parents. For those of you who don't know, me and Hope met in a nice, quaint car park in Billericay. Immediately, Hope was taken aback by my incredible gymnastics ability and my imagination, but she was shortly devastated that the lover of her love at first sight was ducking out to uni. Fortunately to her, the highly prestigious University of High Wycombe, the skirt didn't offer that much, and after 3 years of studying how to write my name sideways, I came back with her on my arm. We've been through a lot and we've achieved so much, and this is only the beginning. Yeah. I want to thank Tracy and Phil again for raising such a beautiful, caring and well-organised daughter. But Nancy, you've had your turn, so that's fine. I'm you're the most amazing person I've ever met. You carry the weight of the world on your shoulders and still bear a smile. Your strength for everything has been it still amazes me every day. And I'm so honoured to have someone of your calibre choose to have me by their side. You're my biggest achievement, and I'm your biggest annoyance. But together we make a team capable of attacking anything. So, bridesmaids, you all look fantastic, and without Hope, I know she'd be very lost, and definitely the organiser like, ooh, blah, blah, blah. I'm struggling, we'll get there. Need a few more guineas. The organisation of the wedding would have been considerably more stressful. I regard myself very lucky to have the friend group I have. We all date back to junior school, and have remained tight ever since. All of you have played a significant role and have supported me and abused me through every obstacle I've ever had. So, cheers boys and girls. Reese, Jack, my two best men, I've known you both for over 20 years and we've got plenty of stories to tell. Jack will enlighten a few, I'm sure. I say Jack only because upon asking them both to, I didn't get quite the answer I wanted. Bruce turned and looked at me and said, "Sean, you can't do it to me, you'll ruin my day." So Reese, I hope today's not been as nerve-wracking as you first thought. You did look after mine and Hope's precious rings, and you did well, so thank you very much for that. I want to finish.
You get a clap.
Jack gets very, very jealous. Jack's very jealous. So Jack got burdened with the hard speech, and when I said, "Oh, Reese would be the ring bearer," Jack, after a pissed up night, called me up and said, "How dare you fucking give him a lovely job?" So crack on.
Reese, come off here, boy.
I want to finish this speech before I set Jack loose on you. I'm saying how grateful I am for all the love and support me and Hope have received throughout the last few years. Be it the strange German scientist who lives on a boat telling Hope to have dog worming tablets, I'm still getting used to her shagging my leg. To all of Hope's work family, she values you so much, and like the support you've given, God knows what that means. But the list goes on. Like, we're so lucky to have so many people to thank. So that's the end of that page. So without further ado, let's raise a glass to all of you lot, to the people we love who aren't here today, and of course, most importantly, my little rockets of a wife and a son.